Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen wa salatu wa salamu ala ashrafil mursaleen Sayyidina wa nabiyyina wa maulana Muhammadin sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam wa ala alihi wa ashabi ajma'in. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We are again privileged and honored to have Hadji Abdus Salaam Ebrahim of PAGAD here, who's our conscience when it comes to drugs. May Allah maintain them, keep them good, inshallah, and protect them. We thank him for being here, and he will address us today. Thank you.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قال الله تعالى في القرآن المجيد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وما حركة الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وأصحابه وأهل بيته وبارك وسلم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. We greet you with the greetings, the universal greetings of peace, justice and sacrifice. Today we would like to address you on the national political elections in this country. And we have to understand, my brothers and sisters in Islam, I would ask you today to listen to us with an open mind. Whatever you thought of the elections, just put it behind you. And listen to us with a very clear mind. And if there's any questions, we are available after Jumuah, inshallah. The verse that we have taken out of the holy book of Allah, وَمَا حَلَكَتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. Allah says in Surah 51, verse 56, I, Allah, have only created jinn and men that they worship me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Very Allah has spoken the truth. Now, if this is the framework of why we were created, then everything we do needs to be looked at this. Now, to look at worship, illa li'abudun. What does this mean, illa li'abudun? Illa li, to worship only Allah, doesn't necessarily only to the short and the small narrative what people want us to believe, that is zakah, salah, hajj, and so on, believing Allah. Illa liya'budun is everything that you do in your life. If it is standing up against exploitation of water or the privatization of water, if you stand up against it that mankind can benefit and not being exploited, then that is illa liya'budun, for the love of Allah. If they overtax you in a country or they give you tariffs that's unbearable on your electricity, then we say, we stand up against it, it is illa liya'budun, that mankind and the service of Allah is in the service of mankind. But if you plant a tree for the love of Allah's creation that they can benefit, illa liya'budun, is for the worship of Allah. If you go to work and you earn halal rizq, it is illa liya'budun. And if you were caught by your brother because he has lied and distorted to his children the position of your haq, of your share in your business, if you were partners to him, and if you shunned him or you challenge him, it is illa liya'budun. It is for the love of Allah. So illa liya'budun. If we find the imam comes to the mosque and word for the people outside the mosque, illa liya'budun. So everything that we do is illa liya'budun. If we run our businesses, must be run that we are in worship of Allah. Even that was given to us is in worship of Allah, that we don't invest in companies. As we see in today, big business investing in companies that is Zionist controlled. That can never be illa liya'budun. So we, in the framework of this discussion, if you leave people in a political system or explain to them what the political system is for the love of Allah, then it is illa liya'budun. So our debate and discussion, keep in our minds that we do it, we are created only managing illa liya'budun. Then we must look at the national political election and the political parties. We need to look at the political framework which these elections are contested in. The framework of these elections, it is a constitution which is based on Western liberal, secular capitalist democracy. Capital democracy. This is the framework. What does this framework represent for us and in the sight of Allah? We have to be truthful when we speak. The framework represents, the constitution represents for us. This, you can build your masajids, we can have our businesses, our private madrasas, we can have our businesses. There is what they say in there is good in this framework. But with this framework comes that your child, when he's 18, he can go to Stodels and buy his dacha plant and plant it at home and smoke it. Your daughter of 12 can have a demand, abortion on demand at 12. Your daughter can go and prostitute herself and you have no say in it because the framework allows it. Your daughter can get married to another woman and you have to accept it by the framework. So you can't take one thing in the framework and reject the other ones. This is a religion that is set up by who? If we go back, we will see it is set up by the capitalists, Zionist imperialists, by the Templars, those who say they believe in Allah and those who reject Allah, those who want to worship multiple gods, and those who want to say Allah doesn't exist. This is all the right. This is what we see thrown in one bowl. This is what we're contesting. This is what political parties, majority of political parties, stands for. So if we look at these political parties, we must look not only at the manifestos, but we must look at what the policy decisions, what is the policy decision. That we have clear understanding what we're dealing with. A believer has an intellect. Allah has given him an intellect. And he must be responsible Qiyamah for his intellect. Now the Bible that they believe in, and that majority of the Muslims and Christians and those who don't believe, the Bible that they follow, the religion that they follow, is this system of democracy. Its preamble is very clear. It states in its preamble that this constitution is the supreme law of the land. And any religious, sports, business, anything, it's subjugated to it. It is supreme to all of it. Your houses of Allah, your marriages, everything. This constitution is their Malik, is their king. It is their Bible. So all they want us to do is to buy into it, where you have people of everybody that say, listen, we are one happy family. When your child gets married to another man, when he's a man, you must be happy the constitution allows it. This is the framework of these things. Now, if any system anywhere in the world wants to succeed, we need to understand what we want. There must be, firstly, a divine concept and submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anything that wants to succeed in the world, any system, Allah must be supreme, Allah must be Malik. A constitution that is Malik itself above Allah can never succeed. Secondly, this system that we want to make you succeed must have taken in consideration the soul of man, the ruh of man, where it comes from and where it's going to and where it's going to be taken account of. Thirdly, its leadership must be principled and divine in its makeup. It can never be a populist leadership, or a person that has money, or a person that pushes fear into the society. It must be principled in the path of Allah. Any system, any party that wants to run for election must have its funding that is pure. It cannot take its funding or support from drug dealers, as we've seen drug dealers is giving money to most of the parties. And then we find parties that is supported by America, Satanic America and Zionist Israel. Many parties. And we must say that we cannot. These are oppositions to Allah, to Allah's book, to Allah's prophet, to Islam and to belief. So when we know these things, what do we do? Where is our options? Then we have the Islamic party will come to us and say, but our manifesto and our principal positions and our policies doesn't include gay rights and gambling dens and all this facade. We are saying you are contesting in an election and a framework that is kufr. Why are we saying it is kufr? Very clear. Let's go to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was approached by Quraysh when they realized Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was gaining momentum. And they made a meeting and a call for a meeting with our beloved master, our Prophet Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, our leader. And they said to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam many things, but in this particular meeting, this issue, where we find this concept of where all parties comes together and kufr and belief is one, they said to Rasulullah, you rule for 2 years and we will respect your rule. And after that, we will rule for 2 years and you will respect our rule. We know they buried the children alive, gambling was there, prostitution was there, unjust wars and exploitation and everything. The wording may be different, but in principle, system of believing kufr, they wanted it. Or they said, let's have a government or what we call today a national unity, where we jointly rule. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told them, we will speak tomorrow. That very same night, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Jibreel to our beloved master and our Prophet Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's exactly what we were partaking in, was offered to him. And Jibreel came to Rasulullah in the verse, Kul ya ayyuhal kafirun wa tayyib. Allah doesn't address them as musrifkun or as socialists or as communists or as capitalists. Allah tell the believers this system. Kul ya will tell the non-believers that they will never accept our way and we will never. And in concluding of that verse, their deen is a deen. Lakum deenukum waliya deen. Your way of life to you and our way of life to us. This is the ayah that was revealed. Don't be confused with politicians and imams that wants to say something else. If you want to contest the election, don't put a Islamic or divine wrapping over it. Be bold enough to stand for election without calling Allah into it, because you are making nonsense of belief. Doesn't matter how big your sheikh is or your imam or your maulana. He is distorting it. He is misleading you on belief. Let's look at the issue of Nabi Yusuf. They say, yes, Nabi Yusuf went into the system of Firaun, so we can go into the system. Nabi Yusuf had something else to offer. Nabi Yusuf gave a direction to the government of Firaun and say that you're going to be in hardships if you don't listen to me. By the interpretation of the dream, that somebody else, Allah gave somebody else the dream, not even a believer. Nabi Yusuf interpreted the dream and warned the government of Firaun, if you don't do this, your people will starve and die. And there will be famine in the land, not only the land, in the world. So we want to put it in context today. If you have in your hand, if people is going to die of a disease, or the country is going to go into difficulties, and you have an answer to it, and you must look after that, the vaccine, and you warn the government that people is going to die. إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ is your, in the duty and the service of Allah, it's your duty to warn that government and to give them direction. And if they employ you to look after the vaccine because you have warned them, there is nothing wrong, it's your duty. It's a difference than to come with a manifesto that promote alcohol, promote gay rights and gambling dens, and tell us it's the same like Nabi Yusuf. Nabi Yusuf never promoted a party or a concept against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they take these concepts from Quran and they throw it to you without you understanding it, and they take you away from Allah. Is there good people? Is there people of good intention in this government? Then I say yes. There is. But your good intention in this system, Islamic party, they say my intention is good, we want to bring a point. Is your point going to be carried in the system of confusion? It's not going to be carried. We see the late Imam Hassan Solomon's, Allah have mercy on him, when the concept of abortion had to be voted out, he stayed at home. He rather paid the 100 rand fine. But he didn't contest, not even in parliament, because his political party is pushing a political line. This is what we must look at, understand. So where do we go from here? What do we do? We have a few options that we can look at. The options that we look at, the current system that we find ourselves in. If we can convince people in this system to tell them, listen, this system is only going to bring another 100 years, is only going to bring destruction, more destruction that we see. Don't look at where you're sitting at. Look at the poor and the oppressed and the downtrodden. Go look how they live and what this system is doing to them. Illa liyabudu, in the service of Allah, in the service of Allah's creation. If you are created, illa liyabudu, if you understand that. So we must convince these people to abandon the system and to look at a new system where people will worship Allah and serve Allah. Secondly, we need to look, if that's not going to work, We need to say to the people and the believers that listen, we need to have a revolution in this country for illa li'abudun, where people will worship Allah, or create a system where we will be able to give them a time and a framework and to look that their hearts will look at how they are going to worship Allah and why they will worship. Educate them in that system and to invite them in that system for illa li'abudun. If not, we must be able to convince the army and the police and those who are in it to say, look at what's happening to your people in this country. You must remember, illa li'abudun, to worship for the worship of Allah, is not for Muslims. It's for the Africa, it's for Asia, it's for Europe. Mankind in itself was only created to worship Allah. Why do we allow people to be taken away from Allah? When we see our African brothers in the townships or other communities living in squalor, in alcohol, in confusion, were they not created? Illa li'abudun, for the worship, only for the worship of Allah? Where is our hearts? So we've asked the police and army, try to convince them that they need to have a good time in this country, that we see that illa li'abudun will come, where people will worship Allah. They will take charge. Not that we see a revolution in that we see in Venezuela, that's not a revolution. Or in Libya, that's not a revolution. Or in Syria, that's not a revolution. And this is what kuffar have started for so-called believers, and they follow like mad people and killing their own Muslim brothers and sisters and children. And this is not in the, this is not in the service of Allah. Otherwise, you must ask the government to let us register for a vote. Let us register for a vote. But put on the voting station, on the voting poll, on the voting ballot, no confidence in system. Let us see how much people is going to put, and let us go to the register. We register and we go to the voting station and we vote. No vote of confidence in the system. Come, you say you are a democracy. Let us see. And let us see how much millions of people is going to vote. No confidence in the system. And let us use that vote then for civil disobedience to bring this government to its understanding that men and jinn was created only to worship Allah. They themselves was created to worship only Allah and to bring a service to mankind in the worship of Allah. The other problem, the other system we can look at, it is a divine system. And I want you to listen very carefully. Is to make, if we look at a position, if it's in Katlehong, if it's in Durban, or it's at Western Cape, we create a space. We call for a referendum and we ask the government that we want to be ruled by a system within a system. We want a space and we can do really people. And in that space, we want make people to make hijrah to that space. People to leave their homes that side with some children and their business to run it, majority that come to a system where we will have a chance with drugs, gangsterism, where shabins, legalization of shabins, prostitution, gay rights, gambling dens, alcohol is not in the equation and in the framework. We want a referendum for that. That we create our own system. We want to run our own funds. Our own taxes, our own police, and our own army. We want that. It may sound for you, what is this man talking about? But if you don't have an idea to build even in 50 years, or 100 years from now, you have nothing in your mind, you only have this system of good and evil all together. You will cry for many years. Your great-grandchildren, Kiamat, will sell their lives and the whole beings and the children to kufr, and they will be in the fire of Jahannam because you didn't even look at what to do to save lives after ourselves. Illa liyabudun is to leave or try to serve a system in worship of Allah, to work for a system that will deliver people even after your time. Your vote is sacred. I want to conclude and I want you to listen to me very carefully. It is sacred, it is holy, it is pure. In the sense is that Qiyamah, you must take responsibility for your vote. If you vote and you know your party stands, manifesto and policy making decision is for gay rights, I'll give you just one. There's many others. Or legalizing of shabins. Every time someone goes and buy alcohol, or someone is asleep, a man marries another man in the system, as long as you made a cross for that system, long after you have died, as you get sadaqah al-jari, you plant a tree or give money to a mosque, that system of kufr and evil of Satan, long after you have died, every time someone does something because you have given him that right, Qiyamah, you will be responsible for it. Don't forget this. Don't let politicians and Islamic leaders, church bodies and synagogues lead you and sway you away from Allah. When you come to Qiyamah, Allah said, every good that you have done and every bad that you have brought forth, Allah is going to keep you accountable. Don't come on the day of Qiyamah with your salah, your zakah, and that, and then you will see on the other side everything has been nullified because of drugs, of alcohol, of prostitution that you have put in place. And then people lead you to the fire of Jahannam, and you say, but my Imam has created me. Your Quran is your Imam. Allah is your God. Muhammad is your leader. Islam is your deen. And Qiyamah is a reality. On this, I just want to say to my beloved brothers and sisters in Islam, we have given you a perspective. We have given you a pattern in the understanding of وَمَا حَلَكَتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. What you do from here onwards, you will be accountable and we will be accountable. I just want to say in conclusion, we thank the Imam, the Mosque Committee. We thank the congregation for giving us this opportunity to give the position and the perspective, the Islamic position on the national election in this part of the world. But we must remember this system that they bring to us, they want to bring to the world, in the Islamic lands, all over. And this is where they want all these crusaders, the Templars, all of them, those who believe to be all in one, they are happy. When you oppose this, they will target you. In closing, I just want to say and greet you with the greetings. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Ashadu wa la ilaha illallah wa ashadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
We say jazakumullah, shukran to Hadji Abdus Salaam Ebrahim of PAGAD for his insightful and passionate deliverance of his talk and advice to us. May Allah bless him and protect him, inshallah. Jazakumullah again, Hadji Abdus Salaam.